When I was a kid, I would always be intrigued on how stuff worked the way it did. I always ask my dad, like, why does this work like that? And why does the car need this battery? And why? And this is what called me to study mechatronics. My name is Victor Armijo. I'm a Mexican mechatronics engineer. We are at the EMBL Grenoble, and here the scientists specialize in understanding the different mechanisms and functions of molecules such as proteins. The end goal for them is to determine the structure of the molecules at an atomic level. So for this, they need very powerful and precise machines and instruments. So we develop those. This is one of our projects. This is an automated machine capable of preparing samples for a specific microscope, which is called cryo-electron microscope. So this is the cryo-electron microscope grid. This is what holds the sample. So it's a metal disc made out of copper or gold of 3 millimeters in diameter. So this is where we will freeze the samples. The only manual part on this machine would be the loading of the grids, and then just load them into the machine, and we add the solution with the sample inside in liquid form. We then freeze it at a very fast speed at cryogenic temperature, and then we store that grid on a box, which we take to the microscope for the scientists to study. So my task as a mechatronic engineer is basically to put all of this together, to cable it, to run the wires, to assemble the whole system, and to kind of quote unquote give life to the whole system. It's a fun job. Sometimes it's very hard because we are developing things that don't exist. And there's a lot of trial and error. This is the cryo-electron microscope. So this is where we bring our samples to a scientist, look at them, and then give us the feedback we need to modify our machine.
These samples that Victor prepares are here. So here, for example, you have a whole grid just in the view that you would see in the microscope. And these dots that you probably can barely see correspond to each protein, but in different conformations. And this is how we can solve it in three dimensions. What is unique about imaging proteins is that we can directly look at the structure of the protein. So different proteins have different shapes, and the shape informs what kind of function they have. Cryo-EM is useful, for example, for the spike protein of the coronavirus. And in general, cryo-EM is more and more used in industry to actually solve structures to develop certain drugs.
So this is my office and the electronics lab. And just as a funny note, here's the Hall of Shame. So every time we make a mistake, we break something or we burn something, we have to make a drawing and put it on the board. Like breaking the gripper from the machines or burning motors. This machine that you just saw, it's still not been commercialized, so it's something new that we are developing. But we have other different machines that are already being commercialized, and they go all around the world to different scientific facilities. It does make me feel proud because I know that we are developing machines that will actually help the human race and the world. So it does make me feel like my job is very meaningful.